Hello, this is Breuer, and welcome back to another episode of our Let's Play for Marvel's Midnight Suns as we continue our normal mode run here. And we do have a new patch in, as of now, I believe. The Venom patch is in, so we might try and check that out at some point in the next couple episodes. But I'm ready to play some more. It's actually been a while since I've recorded some episodes. I've recorded a bunch previously, so I'm glad to get back into this. I'm wearing my, I think this is a Captain America shirt of some sort, so ready to rock and roll. Let's go talk to...
When we avenge the fallen, we honor their loss.
Let's go, we can talk to Strange. We also need to go find the tunnel in the Abbey. So let's go talk to Doctor Strange.
Actually, can I bet you?
I can bet you. There's something you get if you pet him a bunch of times or something like that. We got some credits.
Ah, Hunter, I was just admiring the collection. Someone spent a great deal of time piecing this library together. I hope you don't mind me, having a look around.
Of course not, Doctor. The library is an asset to us all.
I see I'm not the only one who's taken an interest in these works. You haven't been getting into anything precarious, I hope.
I have found something on the Abbey grounds that I think you should see.
Oh, sounds mysterious. By all means, lead the way. I typically avoid venturing this far from the Abbey, especially at night. It makes Tony nervous, you see. There's an unsettling air about this place.
This church belonged to a preacher named Hiram Shaw. His influence turned Salem against its coven.
A charismatic personality and a fearful populace can do much evil together.
There was more to it than that.
Yes, I suspected as much. You were right to bring this to my attention, Hunter.
I thought it resembled one of your wards of protection.
There's a reason for that. It's the same magic Wanda invoked in her attempts to protect the Sanctum. But what is it that you're chasing out here? These wards aren't something to toy with.
I will not know for sure until I get past this. Is there any way to dispel it?
Unfortunately, no. What good would the wards of protection be if they were so easily broken? But I have been wrong before, at least recently. Do you have any suspicions as to who may have conjured this here?
Wanda spent a great deal of time out here, and she had the power.
She does have some experience with these spells, but why would she do that?
The only way I will know for sure is to find a way through to the other side.
I'll think on it and see if I can come up with some way to assist you, Hunter. For now, though, you'll have to be patient.
Alrighty. Thank you, Doctor. So we can teleport back.
Hey, you kept civilians out of carnage. Nice work.
Intriguing.
Oh, I forget what they said about where this could be. It's been a while, like I said, so... Not some hidden entrance somewhere, is there? I thought they said... I don't remember what they said now. Can we see the objectives? Let's see. I'm not going to give us any more information.
Where in the hell are you, Blaze? Something on your mind?
I have heard that Wanda's power comes from K'thon.
The way I understand it,
As a child, Wanda and her family lived in Transia, not far from Mount Wundagore. Within that mountain, the dark god K'thon had long been imprisoned, his corruptive influence an ongoing threat to the people of Transia.
And Wanda was affected?
Whether K'thon reached out to Wanda, or he found her by chance, I can't say. But Wanda was blessed or cursed by K'thon, touched by the power of chaos magic. While he had hoped to make her some sort of acolyte, she proved to be more capable than even he foresaw.
What can you tell me about K'thon?
One of the first Elder Gods, K'thon is said to have existed for tens of millions of years, well before the dawn of humanity on Earth. Believe it or not, he wasn't always the bastion of evil that we know today.
This story sounds familiar.
As the legend goes, the downfall of the old gods was actually brought upon by K'thon's brother Set, who found that by consuming his siblings, he could gain their power. After Set consumed Hypus, K'thon followed suit with the others, and in this way, many of the first gods also became the first demons.
And how did he come to be imprisoned on Earth?
In the same way Hydra has worked to restore Lilith, various cultists of the past sought to revive K'thon to wield his power. When K'thon failed to cooperate, these same cultists did the only thing they could. They locked him away again.
What do you know about Transia?
Transia is your ancestral homeland, Hunter. The birthplace of Lilith and Caretaker. It has always been a sort of magical junction, drawing in every type of occultist, sorcerer, and even the occasional Elder God. The Abbey grounds still behave in much the same way, even after all this time.
And Wundagore?
Wundagore Mountain has always played a prominent role in whatever scheme was underway. K'thon himself is said to have created the Darkhold, deep within the caverns of the mountain.
Apologies for the yawns. I'm not bored. It's been a long day.
What was Caretaker like when she was younger?
I'm sure it's difficult to remember now, but Sarah wasn't always the steadfast contrarian. In our younger days, she was much more enthusiastic about dashing off to save the day. Not unlike some of our younger allies among the Suns.
That does not sound like the Caretaker we know and love.
Keep in mind, Hunter, Sarah has faced a great deal of loss in her time here. Everyone she ever cared about, in fact. I would say she's earned the right to be disagreeable, at the very least. She is a very strong woman. I'm not sure I would have held up as well, given the same circumstances.
Who were the Knights of Wundagore?
Another mysterious group of heroes in a world full of mysterious groups. Of course, I'm no expert on Transian history. I do know that the Knights of Wundagore were formed as a response to the growing threat of K'thon's influence near the mountain.
What exactly did they do?
Hydra was hardly the first to dabble in K'thonic schemes. Many have tried and failed to awaken the Dark God. Over the centuries, the Knights fought alongside a number of allies who stood against the various crazed worshippers of K'thon.
You were there? At the witch trials?
Not initially, no. If I had been, I like to think I could have stopped them before it was too late. I sensed something was wrong, and when the witches cried out in distress, I came to Salem as quickly as I could.
But Shaw had already committed his crimes against them?
Yes. It was a devastating discovery. And for the longest time, I blamed myself.
But you see now, it was not your fault.
I've come to understand that we must accept the past and move on. That doesn't mean I won't always carry that pain with me.
I know that feeling all too well.
I know. And I wish you didn't, dear. I really do.
Alrighty, well, that was a lot of information. Let's see. What is the best? Probably outside, I would imagine, at this point.
Where in the hell are you, Blaze?
If it was here, Autumn would show me.
Ah, but it's down here. Oh yeah, okay, we've seen this fire before. That makes sense.
This must be an ember from the forge. I have the ember. The bottle is not even warm.
If it were giving off any heat at all, I'd be concerned, given the enchantment on that vessel. Now, let's see if this old girl still works.
So I can use the cauldron to brew things?
Essentially, yes. Collect reagents on the Abbey grounds. You'd be surprised what we can make use of.
And I just drop the ingredients in? Is that not dangerous?
That's part of the fun, isn't it? And I see you've already found a recipe book. I doubt you'll have any trouble following along.
Agatha's Cauldron can craft items, resources, and even cosmetic rewards for the hunter. Collect reagents needed for the different recipes on the Abbey grounds. Find recipe books to unlock new recipes. All right then. Wow, that's a. Oh wow, cool. We can actually make essences from here too. That is useful. Common and rare gifts, up to an epic gift at some point. We can do, oh, this is cool, transmutes. That is useful as well. What's the rate? So we got, we can make 25 attack essence with a bunch of death caps and chicken mushrooms, or we can transmute heroic to attack essence for just one Wendigore Everbloom. Now, I'm assuming the Wendigore Everbloom are more rare, but oh, this is very useful. Steel Wind. Palette. Oh, steel. This is a color scheme, I'm assuming. So, alrighty. No, this is actually really good. Anything here we specifically would want? Select a hero. They recover 33% of maximum health. Select a hero. They gain 2 strength and 2 vulnerable. Draw a card every time they KO an enemy for 2 turns. That's pretty good. Draw a card with quick. Free. Gain block equal to their offense for each enemy targeting them. That's pretty good. 1 strength, 1 vulnerable. So this is a regular strength tonic. This is a greater strength tonic. Okay, and we got a greater healing salve. 50% health. 1 counter. Alright, cool. No, there's some decent stuff there. I mean, I haven't really been digging into that stuff. I have a feeling if I was playing on a harder difficulty, we might actually have to use those things more frequently. Alright, anything else for us to do? I don't think there's anybody else for us to talk to, so let's go ahead and go to bed. Get ready for a new day.
What's up, Hunter?
Oh, wow. I like those. It's almost worth getting injuries to get people to get those bonuses now. I'm not saying we should, like, plan for it, but it's just, they're definitely some nice boosts. Ornate chandelier. Let's go.
Hey, can I ask a favor?
Gain a friendship level with Wolverine. Seems reasonable enough.
Thanks, Hunter.
What haven would he be good for? Painting, picnics don't seem like his thing. Meditate, probably not. Picnic, I doubt it. Mushroom hunting, probably not. Fishing, maybe. Seems a little strange, but maybe. I don't really see any that would be like hugely beneficial for him. He don't even have a fishbowl. He doesn't like it.
We ain't built for this.
I disagree. We can still defeat my mother.
No. You and me doing this? Living weapons ain't designed to relax. They make a fella downright resentful.
But all of them are relaxing, so maybe he doesn't have a place to go to.
It is hard to take it easy when the world is falling apart.
For me, it's like there's always a blade stuck in my side. When I relax, it's like I can feel it twist.
How do you handle it?
Same as you. I go looking for a fight.
Does it work?
Not always, but it's enough to dull that blade.
Alrighty, don't we have a Canadian thing? Didn't we find out he's from Canada? Where was the, Canada. Thought there was another one. Oh, Root Beer's Canada.
If I didn't know better, I'd think you read my mind.
He actually loved the activity, and he loved the gift. Nice. Well, that worked out well. So he's ready, I guess, tomorrow to
Hunter, buddy.
Trigger the next boost. So that's done.
Hmm.
Starting to have too many of these gifts. I need to be able to just give these gifts to him, like, randomly, but don't know if there's a way to do that. Without, like, hanging out with him first.
You are here to ask me something?
Your portals. How exactly do they work?
I wave my sword, it rips a hole through space-time, and you walk through it. What else do you want to know?
But is the portal stable?
About as stable as I am.
So, it is not going to crumble all around us.
Look at me. Do I give off the vibe that I'm going to fall apart? Actually, don't answer that. Ugh, fine. I'll tell you how it works if it'll make you feel better. I use my sword to create circles of light called stepping discs.
And these discs are the portals we use to teleport?
Basically. They also double as a party trick for birthdays.
You are joking.
What gave it away?
Alright, there's that.
Nico says I'm Pan. Do I look like a chef to you?
So we can invite you to a haven. What would you be good at? There's two different picnics on here. For some reason I feel like, I mean, he likes to do the whole, well, painting, though? Is he really a painting person? Why not? None of these seem like they fit anybody, quite frankly.
You know what I don't get? Why everyone around has a stick up their ass all the time.
Being a hero comes with much responsibility. Our colleagues recognize that.
Ugh, but it's so boring. Aren't you tired of all the serious doom and gloom attitude?
I think we could all loosen up.
Ha! I knew you felt the same. Being a hero doesn't mean being a wet blanket.
But they are people, not blankets.
Remind me that we need to work on your idioms.
All right, the dynamic debut of Deadpool. Well, obviously, this seems to make the most sense for him.
Oh, we're definitely doing that again.
I actually love the activity, too. So that worked out really well.
Apocalypse, apocalypse. Am I right? Rue Picasso? This belongs in a museum.
All right, who is next on our list? We already got you to 5. Looks like it's going to be Spider-Man's at 2. And we got several people that already got the hearts, so they're ready to, like, talk to us, right? So, guess it'll be Spider-Man.
Well, you know what they say about practice, right?
Caretaker could have at least left me a chair.
I'll be ready to go in no time.
Ready for more?
Yeah, seems like we've got the ability to upgrade. We might as well. Cool. That looks good. Carol Danvers, private message. Yes, because this is her friendship thing.
You wanted to speak, Carol?
Yeah, I just wanted to say thanks.
Thanks for what?
For surprising me with your unexpected friendship. I did not see that coming. Believe it or not, I don't have a lot of peeps I can call friends. Not close ones, at least.
If it makes you feel any better... I never had a lot of friends either. Did not have time with all the demon slaying.
Huh. Sounds like you were like the high school vampire slayer in Blade's favorite television show and Caretaker was that librarian guy. Gifted with greatness, but cursed with solitude.
No, that character had a group of close friends who helped and supported her.
See? Even the slayer had more of a social life than the two of us. I'm glad you're here, Hunter. I feel like you get just how heavy all that extra baggage can be when it comes to having crazy freaking superpowers.
It is a weight you should not have to carry alone, Carol.
Hey, you can carry my bags anytime. You're one of the only people here who has the strength to handle them. Anyway, I should let you get back to whatever cool thing you were doing before I dragged you out here to get all gushy.
Anytime, Carol.
Level 3. Alright. New intel, new gamma. Gain a friendship level with Wolverine. We already got that going.
Where in- Good. I was hoping for something to do. Really good intel here. We've got a lot to go on. We'll cut through that encryption in no time. This intel is hot, Hunter. We shouldn't sit on it for long. Time to spill your guts, Hydra. Well, this was educational. Pick your target, Hunter.
Alright, I think the epic one does seem to make the most sense. Although there is something to be said for going after these ones that are going to expire soon. Yeah, let's focus on one of the expired ones. Who needs a common, modded common ability? Send Wolverine. Get him something.
Where in
the hell are you, Blaze?
Oh, that's right. We can see two of them. I forgot about that. Same thing. Modded common ability. We'll go with... Nah, we'll go with Deadpool.
It's a deadly field cool. trip.
It's good.
I'm here if you need me.
Got more coil for me?
Epic.
Sometimes I even impress myself.
All right, well, definitely don't want to take the dark move. That's not what we're going for. Select an ally, taunt all enemies targeting them, gain 120 block. We've got one of those, don't we? Yeah, we already got one of those. I think it's pretty obvious to take these two. Gains block equal to damage dealt for two turns. This feels pretty good. And then chain two, full combo, gain one strengthened. Gains an additional effect when all attacks in the chain target a single enemy. Okay, that's pretty cool. Which means he gets more offense if he's doing the same enemy twice. Okay. Very, very good. And the upgrade is just more damage. Okay. I think these two are obvious picks. I don't think we have to reroll or anything. Do we have enough for anything? Already done both the challenges. Research is already fine.
Here if you need me.
Got enough money for some upgrade. Do we not have any? Maybe we have one out here. The threat room, which I don't know how much we really need this. I feel like we're getting plenty of experience through what we're doing. It's not like we're, since we're not playing on hard mode, we don't really need to do that. So maybe wait for the crucible. This feels like a pretty useful one in the grand scheme of things. All right. I think we are ready to go on a mission. Let's go ahead and get you edited up. So this is a heroism gainer. Consume block to deal damage, and this one basically gains block from damage. So those are kind of opposites of each other. These are all pretty good cards. I mean, this is a pretty solid card as well. Honestly, one of the shield bounces seems like that makes most sense, which does mean he has very few heroic spenders, but there might be plenty of other people in his group that do have some. Yeah, I think we get rid of that. And that does allow us to upgrade the shield block as well, or shield bounce as well, which its upgrade is... Just apply 1 week. Yeah, that's not bad, actually. I think this will be good for us. So we'll grab that. Looks good. And then who else? Wolverine. All right, lethal pounce. Seems like a direct, almost a direct swap for chain swap. So chain swap does 3, but this is more powerful. Right, that chain swap does what? 57 points of damage. This does 58 when it's all said and done. So they're very close to each other. That from that side of things, they both gain one heroism. This is just less chain. So if it's got a bunch of like minions, it's not as good, but it does work better for big stuff. And it will allow us to upgrade chain swipes. So I think this is the right move. Upgrading this gives us apply. Oh, this gives us apply 1 week as well. So there you go. Cool. I think that works what we wanted. Go. Oh, that didn't mean to do it. Sorry. Always hit the button wrong.
She does not see it happening. You are the best girl. You know that, right?
Let's upgrade those two abilities.
Let's do this. Not everyone wants my advice, but they're gonna get it either way.
Ironically, both of them applying weak to their targets. I like it. I think that works. Let's go ahead and go on a mission. Looking like we're going to be good on time.
Where in the hell are you, Blaze?
Venom missions available. A new story mission featuring Venom is now available on the mirror table. Venom's missions can be undertaken anytime. Blah, blah, blah. We already saw that. Sounds good. I think we will probably take a Venom mission because might as well. We just got him. He's new. Let's have some fun with the new guy. I don't know that I'll be playing him that much because he just doesn't feel like the kind of vibe that I'm going for with kind of the group that I'm going with, but
just because there is talk of a
doesn't mean we can't go do this mission.
Lurking beneath Manhattan does not mean.
Oh, it does. Look, I know Eddie and Venom. They're not what you'd call unsore losers. And we did, you know, kind of bury them under an old bell tower.
Has anyone seen the creature since?
Long gone by the time S.H.I.E.L.D. showed up. They go to ground when you wound their pride. In this case, underground.
Venom on the loose? Licking his wounds?
Now that's a friendly neighborhood problem. So, how about we go solve it?
Do you have a question?
You gotta work on your social cues.
It's Goose Spider-Man.
Are you worried that Venom will hold a grudge?
I wouldn't say worried. I've come to expect it.
And you still think this is a good idea?
Yeah. Eddie tries to be a savior, but sometimes he needs to be saved from himself. Besides, what's the worst that could happen?
He could eat one of us.
Wow, Hunter! I wasn't even holding back or anything! Our slime monster.
Vampire. Ah, vampires.
Maybe it's the Downtown Express?
Sounds like a lair.
Sounds like.
Slime monster.
Time for seconds.
Breakfast for dinner, I guess. With a side of vamp over easy.
Not so easy for the vamp.
Oh, gross, Eddie. It's hard to know who to root for in these parasite versus parasite situations.
Parasite?
A demonically possessed symbiote?
With a vampire's bloodlust.
Not good.
Come on, Eddie, don't do this!
They are definitely doing this.
Fleet blood Venom to complete the mission. Venom's consumption of vampires has put him into a permanent frenzy. Oh, great. Blood Venom's symbiote binds can be broken. Yeah, we know that. Blood Venom won't wait until the enemy turn to launch his attacks. Yeah, we know that. So, frenzy.
I should have known.
Frenzy's permanent.
Thing
good.
Would crawl back to the sewers once Lilith had no use for it.
We have no use for Lilith! We don't need her!
Tell yourself whatever you have to.
Not to interrupt, but have you really been eating those vampires, Eddie?
The rarest meat of all!
Right. So if you are what you eat, what does that make you?
Thirsty.
So we do have the vampire stuff to deal with. I do like the special delivery. This will knock him towards Spider-Man himself. Because Spider-Man has full health, he'll do more damage. Um, fast doesn't really help us here. Because none of these, we're not going to be using a heroic card right this second. I guess we could get to summon a well, no, it'd be his cards. Although drawing two cards could be useful. So if we do that first, then we do this, and then we maybe quick kick, and that's maybe all we do. Can also bind him. Because none of these are going to give me a card play back. Could just special delivery, quick kick, and then bind. Leave the spider sense for now. That might be the best move. Alright, let's do this because we're not going to be high health very long. It doesn't have to be actually at Spider-Man. Although at Spider-Man does do potentially the most damage. Actually, throwing it at her does more damage. This is 337, that's 325. That seems like a good move.
I'm going for it. My Greek mythology is a little rusty, but didn't the Hydra originally have 9 heads?
All right, well, that changes things. That changes a lot of things. All right, so we're going to have to redraw because I'm going to try to get him out of that. Probably redraw this one. I mean, we could do this, which would break his stuff. Still really got to move these guys, though. What I wish is that I could do, like, a big burst on that thing, but doesn't seem like that's going to work. You know, we got one more redraw. Let's do one more redraw somewhere. I'm holding on to Chain Strike because I have a feeling this thing's going to pop some stuff out here in a moment. And I'm going to need the Chain Strike for that. Maybe we get rid of Summon Charlie again. I hate it. I want to use Charlie at some point. He's really good. Alright, we're going to hold it. For now, in this exact moment, we just don't need it. We don't have the stuff for it. Alright, getting patience early is fine. So that way we can start working on it. Alright, I think Holy Burst is the only thing we can do. Break Spider-Man out of that. Do a little bit more damage to him.
Too weak for this fight.
Obviously saw that one coming. Only thing we can do is like knock something back, right? We can take her. We're gonna have to let Spider-Man probably take a little bit of damage here, unfortunately. He does have a little bit of shield. I guess we can actually move him instead. We can at least kill this guy. Does she have a better angle? I mean, she does have an angle to kill two of them or knock some stuff into that. I think killing two of them is probably better. So I think we'll take this. It does mean you'll both take damage here from Venom, but at least it's not that much damage. She's got a shield. He's got a little bit of a shield. It's not going to hurt too bad at the end of the day. We'll be fine. Oh, he's actually got another turn. Okay, I thought it was going to happen already. Alright, so this thing's going to die already.
You're better than this.
So we don't have to worry about that at all.
We are better than Lilith. Better than
personal or even spiritual level, you know?
We know your blood will make us stronger than she ever could.
He has not lost his way with words.
All right, we can leave this guy there to die. Chain strike will be very good here. We can chain strike all three of these things.
Looks like it's up to me.
Now that was something.
Yeah, that's fine. We were going to take a little bit of damage for that, but I think it was acceptable. Okay. I think Morningstar would be a good move here. Would give us enough for the week. Which actually wouldn't be bad. All right, I think we Morningstar him. Just to get it going up in damage.
Lilith herself could not best.
And then even though I would rather like weaken him because he's about to attack, just getting rid of this thing just seems to make the most sense here.
Nothing personal, but I think you're out of your league. How do I get out of this?
Alright, well, we got a knockback still, so let's just knock you back. We can knock you back into that, I guess. Does a little bit of damage. Nothing else will do any damage, actually. I guess that's our only choice. Okay, I think that's all we can do. We'll have to leave him in for now. We'll take care of that later. And we're not going to need both of these, to be fair. And this one does do more damage. As of next turn, it will do more damage. Could just do a quick redraw here to see what else we get. Okay. I think we're going to end there. Bleed obviously hurts, but we'll be all right. Here comes some more vampires. All right, here we go.
I can feel her corruption spreading.
Could just do a heal to get some cards right away. The quick would work really well against one of these two guys, and then we could KO him with the Bands of Fire. Also double all heroes and gains just to get a little bit extra from these couple of cards. Yeah, why not? Let's do that. Double card heroes and gains.
Let us see if they
assuming it will trigger his fury here in a minute. Or frenzy, I should say, here in a second. But I don't think we have much we can do about that. We could start with the Holy Spark. That way, when he attacks us, we can then frenzy, or we can then heal. Yeah. Plus, if he binds us as well, then we won't be able to do anything, and I would like to get rid of at least one of these guys. I think that's the right move. Go ahead and get rid of one of these guys now.
Your mother abandons you.
Ow. All right, we'll definitely need the heal now.
The light will carry you onward. This shall be a good help.
All right, we got the Paragon Collar, which does give us a free light card. We do have Holy Spark, which is, you know, we can take care of this right now. So we will Holy Spark quick the guy on the right, and then we'll whatever we want to do the guy of Venom himself.
Feel my call.
All Ouch. At least he broke it for us. That was nice of you. Oh, no, not the stun. Of course the stun. But the fact that Spider-Man's out might make it okay. We'll have to hope we get a good card here. Because obviously she's stunned right now. We can redraw if this doesn't come up with anything. Really, neither of these really helps us. I mean, strength increases it by 50%, so that'll be what. Yeah, still not enough. We gotta get rid of one of these two. We got plenty of heroism to use patience, so let's get rid of Bands of Fire. Forceful knockback would be okay. Let's just force my knockback into us. Would finish this.
Play dead.
I'm assuming like any boss fight, he comes up here in a second. Sure. Not really much else for us to do. I guess we are. We do another redraw if one of these doesn't look like it's going to be useful. Honestly, without knowing what we're going to get, I think this is fine. We'll just let it go. Oh, she's taking so much damage. All right. So, 430. We definitely want to use patience if we can.
We had our differences, but were they really as bad as this?
We have had enough of all of you.
This is a light card, so we can make this one free. Still might trigger his frenzy, though. But I think we Morningstar him and then Patience him. Can't afford that, can we? Because this will make it... make him frenzy before we can get the Patience off. Patience will give us to 365, which is still not enough to kill him. I think before we can do anything, we've got to get rid of these guys. Do a little bit of damage to him.
Here we go again.
Just in case he like knocks one of us out, stuns one of us, whatever. We've got to do as much as we can to him. Clear up the field. We could start with the patience, I suppose, to do as much damage as possible. We probably should, because we're going to be getting heroism with that anyway. So I could start with the strength, and I wasn't thinking about that with him. I was thinking about the other two guys didn't matter because they were insta-kills anyway. But since the last bit of damage did some damage to him, we should have started with that. It's alright. Could quick knock back him into the stun. Actually, that would only give us one more play, but he would be stunned at least for the first bit. Might skip his frenzy. We're gonna do like 23 points of damage, so it's not gonna do the extra. Surely it will, right? Oh no, it didn't target. Oh, did. Okay, yeah, there's the extra 47. Oh, it still didn't get the, yeah, it didn't target, it didn't hit the stun. That's all right,
stronger than it looks.
I didn't mean to actually click it off. Actually, if you're gonna go for Spider-Man, that's actually good for us. All right, well, in that case we can now, because we have a little bit more frenzy time. Well, no, we still only have two turns. It's so quick. I was going to say we could Paragon the Morningstar into the Patience, but... let's start with the Patience.
Do not bother running.
For such a big damage, it's such a kind of underwhelming graphic for that one, actually. All right, I think we have to Paragon Morningstar now, which doesn't mean it's going to fire off his frenzy, though. Actually, that will do enough. Never mind. Let's not overthink it. Throw a rock at him. There we go.
Demon energy from every pore.
Don't lose it, pal. Either of you.
He is lost. One mercy remains.
Ah, yes. The elimination of one tormented soul for the good of many. Oh, but humans do love a moral dilemma. The umami of an otherwise flavorless existence.
Mephisto.
Gesundheit. nice mullet.
Go to hell.
There's nowhere I would rather be, but I've come on business. So let's make a deal.
Is this one of those fiddle at the crossroads scenarios, or...
No deal.
My terms are as follows. I spare Venom. I cure the symbiote of Lilith's demonic touch. I end the blood fever he's given himself, gorging on curdled vampire bile. I wretch a little thinking of it.
I said, no deal.
All this, and I ask but one inconsequential thing in return. Stop the vampire uprising. The undead are bad for business.
So you cure Eddie and we keep doing what we've been doing?
Yes. Wipe them out. Remove every trace of their foul scourge from the earth. Then I will cure this pathetic creature forever.
For the last time, no.
Hold up. Give me the fine print.
Nothing much. The usual. If you should fail, you'll discover something far more threatening than the undead, namely yours truly, etc., etc., immortal soul, yada yada.
This is a bad idea. This or he dies?
We don't have much of a choice. I'm in.
Good. Just sign there and there. You may feel a little stinky.
Food. Bad food. We will destroy you, bad food.
Go get him, Ed.
We should follow.
You do have a vampire war to wage. Oh, and Peter, I'll see you around.
How did he know my...
Uh-oh, what have you done, Peter?
Of all the surprises we've had so far, that was one of the weirdest. So, that's a truce then, right, Eddie?
Alright, so we got...
We feel like ourselves again. Weaker, but ourselves. We will spare you for now.
Hey, that's progress.
Several minions, several...
Threaten to eat you. That is progress.
More health mobs, and of course the two things on the side. This one about to be popping. That one's got five more turns. All right, what we got? So we got a couple chains. That's actually really useful. Draw one attack or hero card. The next attack card play does not consume a Ravenous. Increases your offense, attack, and heroic abilities. Consume one Ravenous when played. Okay, so fair enough. She's got some damage done. Obviously, we would like to get her healed at some point. We still have the Paragon Collar and the Morning Star available to do 81 points of damage, which wouldn't kill one of these guys, but would get one of them low enough for his Tendril Strike to help, as well as Chain Strike. Okay, I think we... Paragon Collar.
The advantage.
We Morningstar. Doesn't really matter which one. Let's just Morningstar. One that's attacking. Honestly, probably one that's attacking her. Well, No, I probably should keep it close because the chains aren't going to be able to go very far. Alright, so that was free.
You know, you're pretty good at this.
I mean, these are going to pop here pretty soon, so we're just going to have to deal with that when that happens. We can KO 1, 2, 3, and then into 4. Probably should strengthen if we're going to do that, just to make sure we can do as much damage to this thing as possible. Of course, that counted as a card play. All right, so 1, 2, 3, 4. Don't know if we're gonna be able to get his chain thing to hit two people.
Oh, I don't get mad. I get even.
I mean, that was just going to happen anyway. At least it takes damage when it does that. And these are just... these are just normal minions. Actually, this thing might be able to knock out a couple of these things if we lined it up right. I do think we go Trident's Tendril Strike now. Actually, getting a little bit of heroism wouldn't be bad. I probably should have done this earlier, but it's not too late.
The advantage is mine.
All right, the other thing's going to pop now. That's fine. Not much we could have done to avoid that. But we'll be able to get enough heroism to do some stuff here, I think. So Tendril Strike... I'll be able to kill a couple of these guys. Can you get all the way back there? You cannot. Unfortunately, that thing's going to have to stay up. Actually, let's do some of these guys in the middle. Actually, if we can get the guys that are attacking her, she's got the least amount of health right now. Probably better to finish one off. No, let's do that, actually, because I think we can blow up that barrel.
I am impressed.
Guess I could have played this before his other thing, so it didn't consume his Ravenous. Also, I just want to play this for the extra heroism. Okay. So we can do that to kill a bunch of them. Can we do this thing still too? To actually use the mouse here just to get it fine-tuned. Oh, so close to being able to get both of these guys. I mean, it's better to kill this thing, for sure. Oh, wait, is there... I thought there was a point that got both. There we go.
Your time has come.
All right, 5. Do the same thing over here. We'll kill that at least, which again, very critical. Could blow that thing up to kill that guy. I mean, we're starting to lose all use our stuff, but honestly, probably okay to just get rid of these things. Especially since they can't spawn from the things anymore. Alright, I think that's about all we can do. 2 heroism left over will get us... most cards will be able to be within that range, especially once we do another spender. Or another gainer, I should say.
worst headache any ever had. We need a nap.
Almost forgot what you were like before Lilith got in your head. I've kind of missed it.
That would have been nice.
It is your fault Lilith got in our head to begin with.
I mean, I think we definitely heal her. Just think?
I never wanted that. I was trying to keep you from eating my
just
neighbors.
In case something crazy happens. Plus, it gives us a couple more card draws.
Stopping us. Leaving us hungry.
Well, that is kind of my job.
I think this is pretty easy. Kill those two guys.
Once again,
and then just whatever we can do against that guy. Oh, I guess up here looks good. Bit overkill, but it works.
And not a moment too soon.
Come back, Eddie.
You are the man in the monster.
Something like that.
So, you okay, Eddie?
Blood! Kidding, little joke. No, I come in peace.
For once.
Really? New kid's gotta get in on this too? Hey, by the way, you're killing it out there. Respect.
Thank you. Not my first vampire war.
Eddie, are you yourself again? Well, you mean, are we ourselves? Yeah, Lilith. She made us a monster. We did awful things. You know that's not who we are, right?
Of course.
So I'm sitting here. Well, in there, and thinking. I saw what you did for me. So, how about we put aside all our, personal stuff?
Okay.
No, not forever. Just until this whole messed up vampire situation is figured out. Till all the innocent people are safe. I mean, that would make sense, wouldn't it? Yeah. I don't know.
Works for me.
Shake on it. Oh. Wait a sec. Put her there, partner.
I'm there, partner. Welcome to the Midnight Suns.
Well, we got Venom now. Venom is back. All right, well, that's it for today's episode. A bit of a long episode, but got Venom back, so we'll be able to do some of that stuff in the next episode. But I do appreciate you guys watching. May God bless you, and I hope you join me again next time. Thank you, and goodbye. I wanted to give a special shout-out to the following channel members. Thank you so much for supporting the channel.